In this video, you will learn how to create an automation that is gonna automatically post on different LinkedIn groups your post, saving you hours of time. Welcome, RPA champions. I am the RPA champion, and in today's video, we will be using Power Automate to visit every single one of these LinkedIn groups that we have in our Excel sheet and make a post. We'll create a new flow in Power Automate, and we're gonna name this flow with a meaningful name so that we don't lose it amongst all the flows that we have created already. So let's start, and let's start from scratch. Let's start with a blank canvas so that we can see every single step of how this robot is going to be created. So the first thing that we should do, we should open an Excel sheet. And from this Excel sheet, we should extract the URLs that we wanna visit. So let's find the place where we have saved our file, and let's open it with Launch Excel. The next thing that we have to do is we have to select the content of that file. So to do that, we are going to use the Read from Excel worksheet action. We are gonna read from a range of cells, and we're gonna input the cells that we or the range in our Excel notebook where the data is located. So in this example, it's going to be from A1, so that's the first cell, and it's going to go all the way down to A56. So we're gonna have 56 LinkedIn pages. We're gonna go to 56 LinkedIn pages and create a post on 56 LinkedIn pages. Now, let's save this, and this is going to allow us to get that information and put it inside of Power Automate. Power Automate is this amazing technology from Microsoft that is completely free. So I invite you, if this is your first time watching this, I invite you to just type it into Google and download it. The next thing that you should do is close the Excel file so that we don't have Excels open in memory while we are testing and building our robot. Now let's create a loop. So what a loop is going to allow us to do is going to go through all of the content inside of our Excel sheet, and it's going to allow us to visit every single one of the pages that we want to visit and that is inside of our Excel sheet. So then what we need to do is we need to visit all of those pages. So we are going to open a new instance of Google Chrome, and we're going to put it outside of the loop because we're going to navigate to each page. So right now we're just gonna open Google Chrome, but then inside of the loop, we're going to navigate to the different pages that are inside of our Excel. So we have to select the variable that is current item, that is the variable that is currently in the loop or in the cycle that is being executed. Let's put a breakpoint, and I made a mistake. So this should be B because the data in my Excel sheet is in column B, not in column A. So let's test this process and see what happens. So the first step is going to launch the Excel sheet, and it's going to extract the information, save it inside of Power Automate, and then we should open the browser, and the next thing that we should see is the LinkedIn groups page. Perfect. It's going to the first page, so this is working fine. Now let's stop our process and let's record the different actions that we need to do. Different actions that we need to do is we just need to put the text that we wanna post inside of inside of these pages. So let's click the record button, click on the place where we wanna paste the text, make sure that everywhere that we're clicking is highlighted with red so that we know the Power Automate is recording it properly. Let's write some sample text just to see what this is going to look like, and then we should post this message. So right now I'm not going to post it, just to test this process and see if it works. So let's discard the message so far, and let's click finish. Once we click finish, we are going to have generated different steps that we have just completed. So right now we have different steps that have been generated. There is also some things that we don't need, like the comments that are put always at the beginning, at the end of a file that is recorded. So let's delete those. For our process to be complete, we also need to add the send keys action. The send keys action is gonna allow us to send keys to the place where we wanna type in the text that is going to be our post. We cannot spy this text field with the spy feature because LinkedIn is built so that it's hard for robots to interact with it, but we can still work around with the send keys action. I'm gonna paste the text that I wanna post inside of the send keys action, and I'm also gonna simulate it like a human is typing. I will save this action, and this will allow us to send the keys inside of the post that we create. The next thing we should add is a weight. We should actually add two weights. The first one above the send keys so that we make sure that it has loaded properly and that the mouse is highlighting the send keys and that it's ready to type. And another weight right after the send keys. But before that, let's just move the send keys a little bit more above in our process so that they are executed right when we click inside of the box. Let's move the weight above and let's add another weight as well. So we do not need any of these further actions. So let's delete them and let's add one more weight. So this wait will be a little bit longer, like maybe 5 seconds, so that the application can finish, or so that the post can finish loading all of the text and any possible links that I have put inside. Let's test the process out and see how it goes. It has opened LinkedIn successfully. It is clicking where it should be clicking. It is pasting the text like it should be pasting, including the URL that I have attached. It has loaded the content. It is waiting for some time, like 5 seconds. But we forgot to do one thing. We forgot to spy the post button. So that's the last thing that we have to do inside of our process. We have to spy the post button. So let's spy very quickly the post button. Let's stop our process and let's open the web recorder once again. Let's attach it to Google Chrome and to the active tab that we have. And all of this is extremely easy and straightforward to use. It is just next and click. There is no code that is required. So again, let's highlight in red what we want to spy and let's just click on it. And this will create the button that we need to put inside of our process as the missing piece that is going to make everything work. So after we have added that button inside of our process, we will be able to create a process that is going to infinitely post to all of the groups that we want. Let's add this button, save our process. It is good practice to save your Power Automate flows once in a while, because it can happen that the tool can crash. So we have the button as the last step. We have our breakpoints. We can remove our breakpoints and test out our process. So let's just make sure that everything is not going to break. So we are going to add some exception handling, or some very basic exception handling. So since this is a loop of many different pages that are all the same action, it can happen then some pages we cannot maybe post. We don't have the right rights, or maybe the page maybe just for some reason looks different. So in order to avoid that problem, we are going to set to go to the next action in case that action flows. So this will just make us go to the next iteration of the cycle, make us go visit the next page and just try it out on the next page. Hopefully on the next page it will work. So we launched it, we opened Google Chrome, we went to groups. Now it should go to the first group in the page. It should click inside starting a new post. Now we have created a new post. We should paste in the text that we have created. It is simulating like it's typing it. Now it should wait for 5 seconds, and we have forgot to add the right button. So let's go back one more time and let's see what is wrong with our process. So yes, we forgot to add this button that was created and generated all the way at the bottom when we recorded our process. So let's remove everything. Let's add the exception handling on this button as well. And this should make it work. So let's add one more exception handling. Let's remove the comments that we don't need anymore. And let's launch finally our process and see the results. Let's try this for one final time. Now we have fixed our process and it has taken us approximately 10 minutes to create a process that is could potentially save us hours of repetitive tasks. So our process has opened again, LinkedIn, the first link in the page. It is posting the text with the link. The link has loaded. It is waiting for the required time, the 5 seconds that we put. Now it has closed. Now it should navigate to the next page. Excellent. It has posted the post. It's navigating to the next page. And our automation is working. It is going to go through all of the links that we have inside of our Excel sheet, posting our post to all of the different groups on Facebook. Now, I haven't found any limitation to this. I have done it so far on 56 different groups. But if you try to do it on more groups, please let me know in the comments below how many groups can you post this, how many groups can you post it without getting your profile banned, I guess, or without just being blocked as a spammer, I guess. But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you have enjoyed this video. I hope that you are getting more and more into automation. I also invite you to watch my other video where I show you how to post on different Facebook pages so that you can do the pretty much the same thing on different Facebook groups, Facebook pages. So if you have also any requests, please make sure that you leave them down in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.